Right, so here I am, I'm in the house. I'm wanting to put some leg clips onto my main line, but obviously I need to use some rig tubing. Okay. Now you know what it's like getting your line, you're pushing and pushing and pushing, and it feels obviously never ending. My line's not in the best of the shape, as you can tell it's a little bit curly, yeah, from all the hard wax and that lot it's had over time. I need to put a new line on it ideally. So right, how do I get that into there? Pretty quick, you know, it's like you're feeding that through, it takes forever, you feel like it's never gonna go. Right, you want one of these, it's called, and I've done it in one of my videos, but if you've obviously skipped through, then you've probably not seen it. You want a pole threader. Okay, so what you do, you get your end what hasn't got the diamond on it, and you start feeding that in. Now, my pole threader is old. Yeah, it's more than likely got kinks in it and absolutely all sorts. Now, once you've got it going so far through, just literally get your end, well, obviously nothing's coming out. Trap that underneath your foot. Yeah, it doesn't matter if you're on the bank or not. You're not squashing it down. All you're doing is keeping your tubing straight instead of using your teeth and then obviously arm's length and all that lot. Once you've got it straight, then you can start to push your pole threader in much more efficiently. Yeah, keep it going down. Until obviously you reach the bottom, which I think I have. Yeah, let's have a look. And the good thing is with this tubing, it's quite transparent because it's a stony grey. Yeah, and it is literally there. So I've not got much left. You can probably just see it on the camera. Right, so I'm gonna put a tiny bit of spit down that end. Just give it a little blow. And then start to push through again. Now, if you can't push it through anymore because it might be getting kinked or whatever. Yeah, see, arm's length flop, try to do this at arm's length, it's a bloody nightmare. You can't do it. Yeah, because the tubing is longer than my hand. So if that is the case, not to worry. Okay, I've got loads of tubing on that. So a bit like if you're just bearing off a wire, yeah, just trim round, not cutting through, just trim round. And then pull it off, yeah, that little tag end. And then obviously, it's exposed. Grip it with your teeth. Once you've done that, you can start to pull through. Now, like I say, I need to get a new pole threader because mine's donkey's old. And I'm gonna pull through until I get to the diamond, yeah. Now, I'm gonna get my main line. I'm going to trap that inside of there. I'm going to go through quite a bit. Yeah, if you want to, just as a second precaution, you can send it through again. Not that it needs it, but then it's more secure. Yeah, obviously you can pull and pull that now. So in theory then, this should now pull through, okay? Where is it? There it is. So it's on the diamond, which is obviously the thickest part. Let's reach that. There we go. We're going in. Yeah, just keep pulling your pole thread up. So obviously your line is going through like that. And that's it. I'm in. I'm in. That is now onto the main line. Yeah, so I'm going to feed that obviously up on my rod. Don't mind about this. I can trim this off, bite it off, whatever you want to do. Yeah, put my pole threader down there, and the cat keeps looking at it because obviously it's one of them little dangly things what obviously spins around and stuff. Now, I've obviously got to put obviously my ends on, haven't I? Yeah, for making my leg clip. Okay, so one end on. Yeah, then I've got to get my leg clip, which is there. Make sure you put it on the right way around, because otherwise you've got to take it all back off again and then start again, haven't you? Yeah. Onto like so. I can now trap that onto the rubber. Because it's not grabbed the lead on while it's in my bag anyway. Now it's only a cheap chatty one, but I want it to be obviously the same colour. Yeah. That'll pull down, obviously onto that. It's going to be virtually camouflaged to the bottom what I'm fishing. Okay, then I get my rig, what I've not actually got out yet. And then obviously I just attach my rig, so let's do that. Which is here. Right, it's all ready. Yep. Just need to put some putty around that green thing, what you've seen. Now, I'm khaki-handed, so I've got to go this way. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. Box standard grinner. Wet that down. Always important, wet your knots. Wrap it around my hand, because that's going to be into the tubing anyway. Bite that end off. Into the bin. Yeah. I like to bite it off there, because obviously it gives it like a flat point, doesn't it? Of course it does. Right, so now I can actually feed that into my swivel. I've got a pin, so I can lock it into place. There we are, I get my tube in, I pull my tube in down. I might need to make that hole a little bit bigger for this rig tubing. So it's not actually designed for this, it is actually a buffer bead. But I'm using it because I ain't got one, obviously the right colour. There we are, so it's gone into there. So moisten that on. Yeah, so obviously that's onto there, like so. Moisten that, and then obviously now that is going to obviously pull into my leg clip, or push into my leg clip, should I say, if I can see it. Bit gloomy today. Yeah, there we are. And then obviously that now attaches onto like so. Put my lead on there and bait it up. I'm ready to cast. This is our, yeah, fair enough, it's a 7.5 minute video up to now. That's just a quick way. Obviously I've put the full rig obviously onto the main line. Yeah, there were no loops or anything in there. I've just literally done it that way. Yeah, a quick way of doing it. Okay, so obviously I'll have my lead of my choice, which I've actually got here. So if I just take this off my heli-safe, don't you dare go for that, cat. It's swinging around in front of you. It's like a bloody Christmas tree for you, isn't it? Yeah. Obviously then, when I get onto the bank, I get my lead of my choice, which is obviously a Screaming Dalkins one. Wetting that down, push that on slightly, not all the way, as you can see, not all the way. And there's my rig of my choice. Yeah, there's my rig, and then that's obviously ready to be launched out to high horizon wherever I want it. Yeah, so it's just a quick guide on how to get that tubing really obviously on to your main line. Yeah, using one of these pole threaders. Yeah, you can get them from many tackle shops off the internet or anything. There you go. Don't go for that, cat, because that's a sharpened hook. If you go for that, you'll make a yelp. Yeah, and then it'll save me having a blank. Happy days. Thanks for watching. Time to do the next one now.